Good morning, good afternoon, wherever you may be. I am Sword and Keyboard. Welcome to Sword and Keyboard's YouTube channel. I happened to come across this video about a month ago. It's by Jardier, as I pronounce his name. Very popular sim race YouTuber. And basically his video is how to make Assetto Corsa Competition even better. Now some people might take that how to make it even better as an insult to the game. I completely disagree, and I feel that public opinion a lot of times shapes how games are made. And a lot of the devs that I've come across over the years, and I've dealt with a lot of devs because I have a very, well, it's not busy right at the moment, but I've had a lot of rapport over the years on Twitter with devs, and I have a couple large channels on Twitter where devs take notice. Devs take notice to if it's constructive criticism or suggestions or great ideas. They take notice, and some might feel hurt, or depends on, I guess, the approach on how your voice carries over. But for me, on any product that I'm dealing with, or any company that I've ever worked with customer service wise, I always weighed out like people's suggestions and passed them on if I thought they were good. Or I take those suggestions to heart and weigh them out, see if there's something you can do to improve. And I think that's why I'm making this reactionary video to how to make Assetto Corsa. I'm one of many, many, many people that are passionate about the game. The game is really great, but there's a lot of simple things that the game lacks that makes you feel like scratches your head, why wasn't this put into the game? And I'm sure the game has sold a lot of copies by now. I'm sure they have the staff or the means to make these improvements to make it easier for the user, or develop these improvements for future titles. So let's go ahead, this is a reactionary video, let's go ahead and listen to Jardier. This is a guy, 1600 hours in the last 2 years of gameplay.
What are the things that you have to do? But first of all, guys, this video is not about hating the game. This is actually the feedback from the players that enjoy the game, love the game, and they can see some little improvements. So we are trying to give like a little public feedback. So buckle up. So these are the things that me and my community would like to improve in Assetto Corsa Competition to make it even better experience. For example, endurance racing is like the most popular thing you have in Assetto Corsa Competition. You have a day-night transition, amazing cars, other games need to ask. When you do endurance racing in Assetto Corsa Competition,
I'm trying to skip to the point.
Simply a driver swap race with another driver with a friend. Is you are the main driver on the server, he's like a secondary spectator. And therefore, if there is something you need to change on a car for the pit stop, it's impossible. You have to do it yourself. So you're driving on a track, you're like crazy trying to control everything, and you have to 27.1, 27.2 PSI. Hey, wait, 27.4. Oh, okay, damn, it's off. How much fuel did you want? 90 liters? Okay, you can select me as well. Oh my god. Can you please give it to the other driver?
Yes.
To the driver. We have an entry list.
Cannot agree more. Next.
Give the driver in real life stopping in the pits, doing his pit stop or changing his PSI and everything. It's horrible.
Great. Doesn't even have to be an endurance race. It could be just a race with our race with a mandatory pit stop.
All these adjustments, because for example, your teammate is not that experienced and he's driving and he doesn't know what he's doing. He doesn't know what he's doing, and you do it for him. You know, like, don't worry, man. tires and all good to go. Ciao, easy. Now I know I'm not a real racing driver. I used to have like a bit of experience with the real racing when I was way younger. But I think the tire management as a person is way too complicated, and it makes huge performance differences of the cars on the track. Now don't get me wrong, I actually love it. But I think for especially motor drivers, it's way too complicated. You know what I mean? It's basically, let's say an example, your racetrack is 30 degrees.
All right, tire management.
0.77, let's say, optimal tire pressure on the dry tires. But if you change it a little bit bad in the setup, it's 27.9, something like that. And you have 28.2. The front tires will not have an accurate over 20 mil.
Okay, so basically you want better tire management. Here's my issue with tire management in the game is that there's not enough tire wear. I don't know if you'll get to that, but not enough tire wear is a huge issue for me. When a car goes off track five times in a race and does spinouts, the tires should be immediately turned blue, like after the second incident. Like, there should be a serious wear and tear. There's no wear and tear in this game for tires. It's, well, there's wear and tear, but it's nowhere near enough.
It's like, I don't know, 3 p.m. in the game, you have 25 degrees, or 25.3. I doubt that in the spot 24 race, the team is changing. Oh my god, okay, it's 6 p.m. This stint is going to be 25.5, 25.4, 25.6, and 25.7. It's going to be perfect. They go to the track, and in 1 hour, the damage parallel is back in from the car, and he says, guys, no, 27.7, 27.4, 27.3. I don't think it works like that, right? Like, I feel like they have like 2, 3, maybe 4 options of the tire pressures, and that's how they roll in it, right? In real life. So,
right.
I'm not like talking about the e-sport professionals who play the game all the time and they know everything, but I feel like the pressures are a bit too sensitive.
I agree.
So instead of like having 27 for the rocky drivers, it'd be really nice to have like simplicity in this. Because I was listening here, like, they have like pressures for cold, pressures for hot, and that was it.
Okay, it's enough of the tires.
Some file will do something like that. Because every single time.
Oh, of game, course, you could just search.
Firm. You want to skip
this gentleman.
My god. I mean, when I'm a new player, I really enjoy it. Like,
search for this video and you could comment to him directly.
I love the sound, you know, and then for the third time, I'm like, it's getting a little boring, you know, skip. Or if you're in a rush, you know, later on, like, come on.
This video is getting some traction. It has 36,000 views, so. Get in there, put your opinion on there, and let
Ultra. Oh my god.
Eris, or whoever's taking notice of these videos.
We love you so much. But seriously, press escape. Are you seriously confirming you want to escape the game? Yes. I mean, I get it. You want to know who did
right.
it about this amazing game, and I love it.
Why do you have to hit escape twice?
Confirm it again, please.
Yeah, I agree.
In the game, there's a little statistic.
He's trying to be as nice as possible. It's funny.
And all these awesome things, which I think are really awesome, because
it's like the carrot and the stick.
Oh my god,
he's trying to give plenty of carrots here.
Wow, 99 as well. It's pretty cool, right? Can we do something more about it? Like, I feel like it kind of stopped in the development, because I feel like nobody cares about track models anymore. The SA rating is like, I don't know, maybe people don't care anymore, because it's like, there. But you have awesome statistics in the game. And also, when you go to
the statistics of the game are really awesome.
Statistics where you can compare your friends. Like, I can see, like, okay, Dalgan is, oh my god, he's obviously better than Ricardo, but I'm killing those spots on.
Okay. One other thing, too, is,
like, I mean, yeah, you have a Steam friend list. The game actually sees you have a friend list.
The statistics are great.
One friend online doesn't tell you who that is, you can't tell.
But, like he says, they're not.
So, give us statistics per friend list because we want to compare with our friends. I know
right, 100%.
And so on, but these statistics are also very important for us. We freaking are racing. We are racing drivers, and we race this game. We want to compare. I forgot about the multiplayer with the friends list. We also have like a favorite list of the servers, right?
I was just about to say that.
Nice, like every now and then, just like start with something.
How can you have a race game and you can't favorite the servers? I mean, just really. This is like a huge pet peeve of mine, and it really irritates me, to be honest. I mean, just simple things. How could you create a game and not have a favorite server out there?
Positions in a row or stuff like that. Come on, get yourself into a chief to fight for. Probably grow longer. Talk about setups. Setups in this game are the most important.
Yes. Also, you should be able to have fixed spec races for the, especially for the Porsche Cup race. Completely fixed set. Everyone's locked in the same set, so you have an opportunity to do that. I'm not saying every race could do that, but just have the option on the server to be able to fix a setup, So everyone, you could make a race where everyone races the same setup. Or set up shearing. I mean, almost every game that I've played has set up R factor, set up shearing. There's so many different games that have set up shearing. How could you not have a game of this magnitude and not have set up shearing?
Really know that the setup really matters. I mean, yeah, you have an aggressive setup, safe setup, and so on, it's great. But still, you can improve way more, change the setup, use more tag, and so on. But there's so many rookie players, so many AM silver new players coming to the game. And when they look at the setup, they're like, oh boy, here we go again.
Rocky players, that's very true. People that, like, are coming from Xbox and PlayStation and never played on a PC before. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm ready to join the Jardier, whatever his name is. I'm ready to join his choir. I'm gonna stop this video here. I'm gonna make a second video. Let's stop this. The video is running too long. We'll make a part 2.